Okay, good morning, church, and here is a short devotion. Okay, I was thinking from Acts chapter 1 and verses 13 and 14. And when they had entered, they went up, the disciples, into the upper room, and verse 14. And these all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication. Okay, this morning as I was thinking about the disciples, Jesus had been with them, with the disciples for more than 3.5 years. Now Jesus leaves them and he commissions them to stay in the upper room for next till the Holy Spirit comes and comforts them and shows them the direction. And I was thinking even that this week has been a very difficult week, that we lost a very dear pastor, a father, a mentor, a friend, you know. And I believe when the disciples were in the upper room, they were thinking about all the things, the times that they spent with Jesus, the times they traveled with Jesus in the boat, the times where Jesus multiplied, and the times they had fun together with him. And these are amazing moments that they had until the Holy Spirit came and there was a ministry for them to do. In the same way, last few days, that's what I've been doing. I decided to just take a break from preaching from 2 weeks in my church in Masai. And we've been playing Pastor Carl's messages. But I was just thinking about many memories that I have with him. With an amazing, like he's an amazing father figure to me. A friend. We traveled a couple of times together alone with him on the mission trips. Two of the memories just stick to my heart today. I just I say to you, I wanted to share with the church. One of the things is when, I think in 2006 in the month of February, where the Gospels class was going, and after the class was over, and remember, he's a father, we had fun, he's like a friend, we traveled, we had fun times together, but he's also, there are times that he concerned about, he saw the need in us, and we came back from the Gospels class, he told, why don't you travel with me? Actually, if you know, Borivali is from where we had the class to his house is just a minimum fare of the auto rickshaw. So we both were traveling in the auto rickshaw. And we reached the Shivaji Nagar where was his house before. And he said, just sit down. And we told the rickshaw guy to just wait. And the meter was running. And there he was talking about my marriage. And he spoke about, referred me about Sherry. And the rickshaw guy was thinking, what these guys stopped the rickshaw and what is happening? They're talking about marriage and many things. So we had an hour of conversation in that rickshaw. And what is just a minimum fare in those days was 9 rupees or something. But it went on for a big amount. But what's amazing is like we had those moments. And I knew, I always trusted his wisdom. You know, one of the things I love is like his wisdom, he always, like, he listened from God. You know, I know whatever comes, he was true to what he said. And that's how, that's the day we had, I thought about Sherry. I think in 6 months, got married in October. What an amazing marriage, and he was in it, in our marriage. The second thing I was remembering was our first trip ever to Orissa, me and Pastor Kalmin, our first trip in 2008. And I remember that time we didn't have much like funds and all. We were traveling in a train. We were traveling in a second class train and we reached a small village like Vijayanagaram. And that's where Pastor Pradeep Lima came to pick us up. So we landed at 12 in the night and our train was again from there to Raigada at 2:30. So Pastor Carl was like, we had outside on the road, we had this roadside idlis. He likes the roadside food. We used to have fun eating like hot idlis. And after that he came and I remember he slept on the bench of the railway station and he slept off. And suddenly in just 1 hour later, Pastor Pradeep has said, Pastor, our train has come. And immediately Pastor Carl and me got up, we ran into the train and we got the train and we got into the train because it's going to stop for a few minutes. And we got into the train, we went into our bogey and there was somebody sleeping there in our place. You should see the reaction, and Pastor Carl, literally we woke that guy up. We woke that guy up and said, Pastor Carl was showing the ticket, train number, this is my seat. And that guy is like a village kind of guy. He got down, he had a trunk kind of box. So he opened that box, it's all happening in the 2 in the morning. And he opened the trunk box and he removed his ticket. And he sees, he had the same birth, we have the same birth. And by the time we didn't see Pastor Pradeep Lima, he had somewhere a doubt that we were in the wrong train. And he found out it was a wrong train. By the time Pastor Carl is saying, Baya e amara seat. Now you know how he talks Hindi? Baya e amara seat. And I am trying to support him. And then slowly Pastor Pradeep Lima comes and says, Pastor, this is the wrong train. Then I slowly went to his ear and said, Pastor, I think you should stop shouting. It's not our seat. We are in the wrong train. Okay, sorry Baya. And he made him and we just quietly came out. And even today we laugh about that event, even whenever we meet and talk about Orissa and whenever we go to meet Pastor Pradeep. And those were some of the moments. There are many like stories like that now, but these are some events that we had fun times together. We had times in going out to coffee, and one day he took like six of our men. I remember like six of us, we went to resort and we played in the jacuzzi together, and it was a lot of fun we had. There are many fun moments. I can go on and on. But it's amazing what I'm saying is, the end of it is like the last words of Pastor Carl was, the last meeting that we had was the night before he went to be with the Lord. And we were with him almost like 8:30 in the night, and morning at 6 he was no more with us. But he said two amazing words that stick to my heart very dearly. One was, he spoke about humility, and the number two was unity. I was thinking about these two words, humility and unity. You know what? You can get the best dictionaries and find out the meaning. But you know what? These words, he didn't have too many words, sentences to stay because of his health issues, but he had these two powerful words, unity and humility. And you know what? I can today go back and think about those verses, those words, and ask the Holy Spirit to minister to me what is humility is, what is unity is. Because it is very important things as we think about, in Acts chapter, the disciples were in one accord, in unity, and there was a revival. In Psalm 133, there's a blessing forevermore when the brothers dwell in unity. You know, unity always complements with humility. Unity cannot happen without humility. I think these words are great words that I will treasure in my heart, and I'm going to meditate on this for next few days. And I have many more stories. I'm just writing journals about things that we remembered about him and memories we had. What an amazing pastor. We love him, and so all of you are. Thank you, and keep praying for Sue and Andrew and the church. Amen.